Four more races have been added to this year's Formula One calendar, including a return to Turkey's Istanbul Park for the first time in almost a decade. I'm Thomas Maher. Be sure to like and subscribe for the very latest Formula One news. Formula One has confirmed four more races on their calendar to close out this season's disrupted schedule. Cramming in four more races means the total number for the year is 17, five short of the original plan. F1 also confirmed that the postponed Chinese Grand Prix will not be happening, having failed to find a date suitable for hosting the event this year. The Turkish Grand Prix returns to the calendar for the first time since 2011, having made its debut back in 2005. This race is scheduled for November 15th. Following on from that, 2 weeks later, Formula One spends two weekends in Bahrain at the Sakhir Circuit for a doubleheader on the 29th of November and the 6th of December. Formula One then decamps to the United Arab Emirates to conclude the season at the usual final race at Abu Dhabi's Yas Marina. This race will take place on December 13th, meaning this race will clash with me doing my Christmas shopping. Some of these races will be open to limited amounts of fans, with F1 saying, "We can confirm that a number of races in the revised 2020 season will be open to a limited number of fans, including hospitality, and we're working with each promoter to finalise the details. While we want to see as many fans as possible return as soon as it is safe to do so, our priority remains the safety of the Formula One community and the communities we visit, and we review fan access on this basis. We're proud to announce that Turkey, Bahrain and Abu Dhabi will be part of our 2020 season," said F1 CEO Chase Carey. "This year has presented Formula One and the world with an unprecedented challenge, and we want to pay tribute to everyone across Formula One, the FIA, the teams and our partners who have made this possible. While we're all disappointed that we've not been able to return to some of our planned races this year, we're confident our season has started well and will continue to deliver plenty of excitement with traditional as well as new races that will entertain all of our fans." Are you excited to see the return of Istanbul Park? I have a sneaking suspicion that Turn 8 will not be as spectacular with the modern F1 cars. All the extra downforce on the cars these days means Turn 8 should be a lot more simple for them to take quickly compared to the cars of around 10 years ago. For this reason, I think it's going to be a little bit underwhelming. Keep an eye out on selling sites for Pierre Gasly, as the French driver has had his home burgled with the loss of personal items. He's urging fans to keep an eye out for items that may belong to him appearing on selling sites after his home in France was ransacked. Returning home to Normandy after the recent run of three races at Silverstone and Catalunya, Gasly discovered that his house had been broken into, and plenty of personal items have been stolen by those responsible. In a message shared on social media, the AlphaTauri driver said, "Some people are really worthless, disrespectful and despicable. I got robbed and my house in Normandy was ransacked. Items stolen include BRM watches with his name, Tag Heuer watches, jewellery, clothing, glasses and some of his racing helmets. Pierre is requesting anyone who spots any suspicious merchandise for sale to contact him, or if you have any information that may help in the recovery of his property. I was really upset to discover that my home in Normandy had been burgled while I was away. It was not a pleasant experience to realise people had been in your home and stolen a lot of personal items of my family and mine." That's it from me for the moment. Don't forget to like and subscribe and follow me on Twitter at Thomas Maher on F1.